In the spirit of the Super Bowl, a football trivia question. What do quarterbacks Tom Brady and Kurt Warner have in common? First, they both are Super Bowl winners, and maybe again, and recipients of the league's MVP player award several times. But what they also have in common is they both were given very low chances of ever making it onto an NFL team roster, let alone becoming all-time league greats. Brady was drafted by the Patriots as the 199th pick in the draft. He took over as starting quarterback only after an injury to Drew Bledsoe. This year, he switched coaches, cities, and conferences, and at 43 is back in the Super Bowl. Warner was not selected at all. He tried out for the Packers in 1994, was released before the regular season. No team wanted to give him a chance. He stocked shelves in a grocery store for $6.50 an hour and played in the Arena Football League. He was supposed to try out for the Chicago Bears, but was bitten by a spider during his honeymoon, and therefore he played for NFL Europe. He signed with the St. Louis Rams in 1998, and after an injury to the starting quarterback, took over, and in 1999 had one of the best seasons of any quarterback in NFL history. Given what we know about their careers, this is almost impossible to imagine. They were actually part of a legendary group of quarterbacks who, according to current NFL draft rules, would never have been selected, including Hall of Famers Johnny Unitas, Bart Starr, and my favorite, Roger Staubach. Each of these players are great examples of outsiders who made a game-changing impact. But it could easily have gone differently. Any of them could have allowed the lack of interest from teams or from the public to impact their self-confidence and their resolve to play the game. In our parsha, we encounter an outsider, Yitro, someone who could have looked at the reality and turned the other way, but chose to make a difference instead. Yitro saw a group of nomads forming into a people of purpose and recognized a problem that had to be solved, that could dramatically improve their lives. But he knew that his advice might be ignored, not only because he was an outsider, but because he was trying to give advice to his son-in-law, Moshe. Yitro had passion, he had resolve, and he wanted to make a difference. He saw the entirety of the field. He saw the big picture and the adjustments that would be necessary in order to make Moshe into the most effective quarterback for the Jewish people. He saw that in order for that to happen, Moshe had to learn to share the burden with the team. And so Yitro overcame any self-doubt, any societal opposition, and ended up radically shaping the Jewish people's judiciary system. It freed up Moshe to focus on leading the people on the important issues facing them at the time. How many times in our lives do we have the opportunity like Yitro to make a difference? An opportunity to grow in ways that requires us to stretch ourselves to our limits. It's almost always easier to simply ignore the opportunity. We convince ourselves it's too difficult, we might fail. Worse, others may think we're not capable, but imagine pro football without Unitas, without Starr, without Staubach, without Warner or Brady, any of whom could have easily chosen the simpler path of accepting the poor assessments of others about them. Imagine the destiny of the Jewish people and societal jurisprudence without the brilliant guidance of Yitro. That's why he gets a parsha in his name. We all have the opportunity to make a difference. Let us resolve to do something more, to make our lives, the lives of our families, the lives of our community and society, even just a little more meaningful. Our position on life's playing field is not decided by a draft or by coaches or by popular opinion. It is decided by our resolve, our persistence to fully actualize our God-given potential. Shabbat Shalom.